Soon, Tesla Giga Berlin Model Y will get a big range boost. But how much? Tesla wants to launch Berlin Model Y this October at Giga Berlin. An updated Model Y is on its way to Europe with 4680 battery cells. But first, Europe will get a Model Y from China. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel and give us thumbs up if you find this report helpful. So the production of Model Y is expected to start in October in Berlin-Brandeburg at Giga Berlin, construction of which is being completed. The updated Model Y is expected to feature tabless 4680 battery cells, offering an increase in power and range over previous versions of the crossover. But how much of increase of power and range? If you have any idea, please let us know in the comment section below as I continue to telling the story. After months of delays, Tesla Giga Berlin plant is expected to be on its way to launch in just a matter of weeks. Tesla CEO Elon Musk indicated a couple of days ago that the automaker expects the plant to the company's first in Europe and second outside of the United States, to begin production of the Model Y starting this October. Earlier this summer, CEO lamented that the plant had become mired in bureaucratic hell as the automaker raced to get the facility ready amid record EV demand in the European Union continent of the Europe. So the Model Y electric crossover will be the first model the Berlin-Brandenburg Gigafactory plant is expected to produce, and is easily the most important vehicle for the automaker, both now and over the next couple of years. Besides the Fremont, California plant, Tesla currently produces the Model Y in Shanghai, with the Austin, Texas and Berlin plants being the two next planned locations for the production of Model Y. The Model Y itself is due for an update. That's why I started it with this, with Tesla planning to give it a refresh that will include a structural battery pack featuring the upcoming 4680 cells, the same ones that are also bound for planned Cybertruck production. The 4680 cells promising greater energy density, lower wave, and a longer range are expected to give the Berlin-made Model Y a range boost, though the extent of that boost is not known at the moment. Friends, Tesla said during 2020 Battery Day that it aimed for a range boost of up to 54%. That's significant, right? A very significant bump that could potentially bring the range of the Model Y to between 450 to 500 miles. Now, how many of you believe Tesla can do this in the next couple of months? Here's a quote I want to present you. Of course, there are a large number of factors that come into play with the implementation of this new tabless battery design, so it's a little early to talk about what increases we could see in the EPA rated here in the United States, notes J. Remy in the Auto Week. He says, if the production of the Tesla Model Y electric crossover with the 4680 cells starts in Berlin without further delays, we should soon get an idea of the range increase the Model Ys could expect. Tesla will obviously announce that soon. However, before Model Y buyers in Europe and in the United States receive the updated crossover, buyers in Europe could receive Chinese-built Model Y made in Gigafactory Shanghai in a matter of days. The first ship with Model Ys from Shanghai was reported to be en route to Europe a couple of weeks ago, with the first examples and first units spotting in Europe on car carriers just days ago. Plans to launch Model Y production in Berlin and Austin after Shanghai underscore just how important the Model Y has become to Tesla and how relatively less important some other models have become for Tesla. Do you agree? I have felt that way. For example, Model S and Model X production has been absent for a large part of this year, but appears to have minimally affected Tesla's profitability over the past two financial quarters. Other upcoming models like the Cybertruck, on the other hand, are not expected to be a significant factor in sales outside the US at all. But Cybertruck will become a very important sales factor in the United States once it comes to production. Now, in the meantime, the Tesla Model 3 remains by far the best-selling electric car worldwide, and Model Y would be its direct crossover relative if it weren't for the Chinese mini electric car Wuling Hongguang Mini EV. That comes from global figures for the first half of 2021, which the info service EV Volumes has now published. Overall, the electrical part of the auto market recorded growth of 168% compared to the Corona week first 6 months of 2020. So compared to the first 6 months of 2020, we have grown 168% in terms of EV sales. Tesla is at the top of the top 10 worldwide. According to the number of EV volumes, the Tesla Model 3 was shipped 244,000 times worldwide and the Model Y 138,000 times in the first half of the year. Between them, the Mini from Hongguang has been sold 182,000 times, which is only 5,000 euros, which is available in China. After the Model Y, nothing comes for a long time. And then with the BYD Han EV, 39,000 unit sales, another electric car, and for China, and almost on par for the world's electric car ID4 from Volkswagen. In the second part of the top 10, in starting from 6 to 10, there are two more Europeans, Renault Zoe and Volkswagen ID3, two more Chinese cars, and the Hyundai Kona Electro from South Korea. So this is the general picture of how the Model Y is comparing to the rest of the car makers. EV Volumes includes plug-in hybrid in its data on electric vehicles. That means electric vehicles, and does not always mention the pure battery portion. For the first time in the first half of 2021, however, all vehicles were in the global top 10 pure electric cars. The service notes, and according to the service, a total of 2.65 million new electric vehicles were sold in the first half of the year. For the whole of 2021, the NOW expects further growth to 6.4 million sales worldwide for a share of 69% for purely electric cars. Friends, Europe stands out in that the proportion of plug-in hybrids is much higher than that rest of the world. According to electric vehicle EV Volumes, it was recently around half compared to just 20% on average for the other countries. This could be related to the generous use of plug-in hybrids on the continent where many important car manufacturers are based. The EU fleet bold balance includes rechargeable combustion engines with unrealistically low CO2 emissions per kilometer, and high CO2 emissions also apply to them in Germany, for example, when they have a lot of purchase rewards. Well, let me know what your thoughts are. Back to Model Y. Model Y seems to be leading a lot of charts these days. Model 3 is the top, but Model Y is coming very strong. And what do you think the new range and new power boost will be of the Model Y once it comes updated in basically 2 months if things go right and Giga Berlin is immediately approved? But as I've said in my previous report, it may take at least a month or several weeks for Giga Berlin to be up and running, because it's not like the next day after the approval, the first Model Y refreshed with 4680 battery cells will roll off. But what's interesting is that we haven't heard any updates about the 4680 battery cells. We don't know where they will be coming from exactly. I mean, we have some information in the past that different companies that partner with Tesla have talked to Tesla, been building them, but that hasn't been any big news. Like, for example, we haven't heard any big news that 4680 batteries ship from Fremont or from Southeast Asia, Panasonic or Samsung or CATL, to Giga Berlin, right? If you have heard anything, please let me know in the comment section below, friends. I would like to see that, and maybe we can report an update on that. But so far, we're looking for the approval of Giga Berlin. A lot of exciting things are happening. Things seem to be going in the right direction. There are lots of complaints and objections against Giga Berlin 244 that are going to be discussed. After that, the government will convene and the environment office will probably give the approval, and we will see when the first Model Y electric crossovers made in Giga Berlin will roll off of the assembly line from Grünheide. This is Armin Harayan from torquenews.com. Please subscribe to our channel, join our community. We have really great discussions, if you can see in the discussion of our previous reports, and also give us thumbs up for this report and sharing social media. We would greatly appreciate it. Have a great day. God bless you, everyone, and see you soon in our next report. Peace be with all of you.